I don't think that's the one. Is you made like that? Yo, of course I am. Is you made like that? Yo, of course I am.
What's up, guys? This is Qazi. Welcome to another epic video in a 2-Minute Tuesday series. This time, I'm going to be showing you 2 easy steps to get a film look. If you casually color grade your projects but want to learn more about nodes and how to build a proper node tree, you came to the right place. In this free training, you're not only going to learn everything about nodes, you will also learn to build the perfect node tree regardless of the project that you're working on. I will end the session with an extended Q&A. These questions came from you guys. Click the link in the description to sign up for this free training. And guys, if you're enjoying the content, you know what to do. Smash that like button, subscribe to my channel for more awesomeness. Make sure to follow me on Instagram, and let's roll the intro. All right, let's get started. So obviously this is not a full-on color grading video, so I'm not gonna grade this entire project because I wanna focus on showing you the 2 easy steps to get the film look. So let me just give you a quick breakdown on what I did to get to that point where we're gonna be applying those 2 techniques to get the film look. So I started off with my primaries just to balance everything out. But obviously, it threw off my yellows and my reds and all that. So I went in my HSL curves and tried to bring back some of that information to look realistic. Then I went and added some contrast using my contrast and pivot right here. Then we moved on with our log wheels just to get our black points looking right. So did that and grabbed the skin, pulled it out using the HDR palette, and then created a vignette. You just kind of suck everything out that is not important around the image. And it also cleans up a lot of this like cables and things that we can see on the ground. It takes care of all of that. Then went ahead and made some look adjustments because there's still a lot of red sitting in my image that I don't like. And I want to create the stylized look. So this accomplishes that. And then the most important note is right here, number one, which is basically highlight recovery node, and I'm using HDR palette, and just look what it does, like how much of her skin comes back, the shirt and everything, and she becomes the main focus, not to mention the amount of information we're bringing back in the fire. Just look at that. So if I do before to Rec 709 to after, we're almost bringing the same amount of information, yet we added so much contrast and there's so much to our image. Okay, so this is where we sit right now. Now what I'm going to do is create 2 more nodes and grab them, pull them down, and let's start naming them. So the first step to getting a film look is going to be glow. And then the second step is going to be our film grain. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead in my glow node, click right here, and then just type in glow, drop that on. So first, when you drop it on, it doesn't really do much. The key here is to go under your composite mode and change it to soft light, okay? It's still not really doing what we want it to do. And in one step, we're going to be right there. So I'm going to go on my panel to access these controls. And I'm going to do is go under my threshold and keep cranking it back to this, okay? And now when I crank it all the way back, I mean, just look at what it did. So because we built out our image right, we just had to do this much to get that film look. Like, look at the blooming effect that's happening around our highlights. Like, look at that. This is what people put pro mist filters and do so much to get that film look. And just even look at around this desk, like, or piano, actually. Like, look at the glow that we're getting around everything. And it looks so natural. So that is the first step. Like, look at right there. It goes from this weird digital blown out highlights to this beautiful blooming effect that we're getting by using the glow and the technique that I just showed you. And then the next thing we're going to do here is, now one thing that I do see is that after dropping that on, let's see if we can go back to our first node and try to recover some of those highlights. So what I'm going to do is go under my highlights here in my HDR palette and start dialing that back. I'm going to be kind of aggressive and then I'm going to go back up. So we basically dropped another stop. We were at negative 1.24. Now we're at 2.24. So we dropped about a stop, but just look at the amount of detail we're bringing back. So to be honest with you, I am liking that. So, I mean, if I go back, right? If I go back here to 1.24 to like getting all that information back, I think I'm buying that way more. So I'm going to leave that there. And then the final step is going to be, let's go to node 10 and let's go to grain, film grain, and just drop that on. And now I'm going to exaggerate it for YouTube so you guys can really see what I'm doing, but you don't have to push it this much. Okay. So first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and make my image bigger so you guys can really see it. And if I do before and after, I'm sure you guys are not really able to see it yet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go under my film strength and or grain strength, and I'm just going to crank it quite a bit. And then I'm going to go under my grain size and crank it. And once again, guys, I'm doing this so you guys can really see it. You don't have to push it this much, although there are times when I've pushed it that much because I just love film grain that much. Okay. So if I make it bigger and show you now what we got going on, if we just grab these two nodes and if I toggle them on and off, so I'm going to get rid of this for a second. And if I toggle it off before the film look, the two easy steps, and then after the two easy steps, I mean, look at how natural and film like this is looking right now than before. Before there was like a lot of this artifacting going on. And just look at the blooming effect that we got going on. And the grain just ties the whole thing together. So, I mean, if I really do before and after, I mean, just look at that. Like where we started this entire image to where we ended up. But if we just focus on these two steps to what they did, I mean, this is a huge difference. So this is what I'm trying to tell you. Okay, this right there, because I mean, you can turn in your image like that and it looks really good. But imagine turning it in like this. So a quick little extracurricular thing that we can do here that I completely forgot to mention. Let me just click on our skin node and we see that this is where our skin is selected, right? And if I go under my glow node and turn it on and off, we see that I really enjoyed and liked my skin way better before we dropped on the glow, right? Because this just got way too red and that's just not accurate. So in this case, what we can do is just take the output or the key point from this node, which is where our skin is selected, and send it to endpoint into our key. And obviously it's going to look all wrong. So what we need to do is click on this guy right here, node key, and flip it. So now what we're doing is we're leaving the skin as is, and we're affecting and adding the glow around everything else. Now, one thing that I like to do to just really have it blurred in and look much better is just take this blur radius and start cranking that up. Okay, so it kind of blends in better. And now if we look at the two, just check it out how much better this is. So that would be one final step that I will consider for sure. Now let's check out the final look in full screen.
Is you made like that? Yo, of course I am. Is you made like that? Yo, of course I am.
So there you have it, two easy steps to get a film look. Do not forget to watch the free training, link is down below. And if you're enjoying the content, smash that like button, subscribe to my channel for more awesomeness, and remember, work hard, get obsessed, get possessed, and I will see you guys in the next video.